I think this is one of those lenses that you can it's a combination of lenses. You want to do something with the elements, but it appears to be several different focal lengths. There's 635 at 25 inches. Back, I guess that'd be 19. No, back 19. And back 19, so it's 7 inches at 500.4 millimeters. I don't know what 19 is, but there's no other information on the back of this ring like the front has. I haven't done anything to it, like try to clean it or anything. Yeah, there's a little bit of dust in there, but there's no fungus or anything like that. Let me set it over here. We can look through it, hopefully. You can see where it was cemented. And you can see some dust. There's no scratches. And the back coating appears to be like coated. I don't know if it's coated or not. But again, you can see like the cemented edges. I looked online at some of these lenses and I noticed they all look the same, so I'm not really concerned with those jagged edges, so I'm sure they don't want to affect the image quality at all. You can see inside the lens is pretty darn clean actually for as old as it is. And these unscrew so that dust will blow right out. There's some patina on it, so it's obviously it's brass with enamel, I would say. The lens board threads are clean. But there's some patina right there. You can see it's like a light green. And the threads are pretty clean. I guess a small brass brush would clean those threads out. These two screws are a little rusted, so I assume that those are not brass, they're not stainless, those are steel and they've oxidized, so it should have been chrome plated, I assume, considering they had chrome back then, because the shutter release looks chrome plated. That could be nickel, actually, probably is nickel, maybe chrome, I don't know. Did they have chrome back then? Patented August 13th, 1912. I'm sure this lens isn't from 1912, but I'm sure it's an old sucker. Let me pull out of that macro, the Telemac. Let's take a peek at this baby. See, without Telemacro, I can't get in real tight without the camera blowing out. So that's why I was doing that. So this is the lens that I got for $100. The aperture works fine, there's no doubt about that. It's nice and smooth, there's no oil on the blades that I could see, so that means, I guess maybe this isn't like a normal lens that I'm used to, because when I say oil on the blades, those lenses in the focusing area inside the lens, there's grease and it breaks down and seeps oil onto the blades. But there is a little bit of looks like oxidation on the blades themselves. But I mean, I could be nitpicking it. It's definitely an old lens. Now, when people ask, does it have a flange? No, I don't see a flange. I assume that they made this lens as a flanged version. Instead of being screwed to a lens board, it would have a 4 square holes or so, or a flanged mount to a wooden board or a lens board, and that would be beneficial. There you have it. Takes, haven't even cleaned the actual glass. Smudged up, but those are not scratches. It's fingerprints from people touching it. I just got this today from, you'll never guess where. I got it from the Pawn Stars. It was in a 4x5 view graphics camera. They wanted $900 for it. And inside the box, there was this lens, an 8x10 lens. I think the guy's name was, heck, I can't remember. But there was a person's name on the box, Bob Penn, or I think that's what his name was, Bob Penn, P-E-N-N. He had a camera. So this is the lens that I have, and now I get to go edit.